So, you're ready to build a sheet in Smartsheet. But how do you define and manage the information that goes into it? Good news is our sheets have columns with unique properties that make it easier to define those details and manage your work. The way you set up your columns impacts more than your sheet. It'll impact reports, automation rules, dashboards, and more. Let's review all the types of columns you can use to power your sheets and how to change the properties of your columns. Though before you ask, yep, you must be an admin to fully manage, control, and move columns around. First up is the primary column, which is the foundational column in any sheet. It's for key information. For example, my sheet is for tracking tasks, so I'll call the primary column task name to keep it simple. If I want to build a hierarchy in my rows, I can indent and outdent rows in the sheet's primary column. It's important to note that the primary column is the only column on your sheet required to use text or numbers. In my task name column, I'll just enter the names of tasks as I add them to my sheet. If you want to change a column's properties, no sweat. Just double-click or right-click on the column header to edit the column's name or column type. Let's look at all the other column types. You can choose from the following columns: contact list, date, drop-down, single select, drop-down, multi-select, checkbox, symbols, auto number, or system. So, what do all of these column types do? We're happy you asked. Contact list columns make it easy to assign rows to contacts from your Smartsheet contact lists, made up of your colleagues' names and email addresses. In my sheet, this makes it easier for everyone with access to know who's assigned to what. Most tasks are time sensitive. Columns with date properties let you view dates on a calendar. Very useful for setting reminders in order to make deadlines. For this project, I need a more in-depth timeline, so I'm going to set up start and end dates in two columns to view the work as a Gantt chart. This helps keep my team on track to complete key milestones. Drop-down lists are great for making your data more consistent, organized, and easier to work with. Once I add one to my sheet, I can then switch to card view to organize and prioritize tasks in different lanes. You can even add multiple list items to a column by making it a drop-down, multi-select. Fantastic for when multiple items apply to the row. To tell your team that a work item is complete, I recommend adding a checkbox column. These checkmarks are easy to scan. Speaking of sharing information at a glance, we also have symbol columns. You can pick from our library of symbol sets to report on status, flag urgent items, or star your favorites. We also have auto number, modified date, modified by, created date, and created by column options. Auto number properties make it pretty easy to track items by giving each row a unique ID. The other system-generated columns are great for tracking created dates and modified dates, as well as who created or modified a row and when. Like I mentioned earlier, you have to be the owner or admin of the sheet to fully manage its columns. This includes inserting or deleting columns, renaming columns, and changing the layout of columns. Only owners and admins can hide and lock columns, which stops people from editing data within them. If you're not the owner or admin, you can still sort or filter columns to view subsets of the sheet's data. I'm going to save a new filter on my sheet and share it with my team so that everyone has access to the same view of the data. This is especially useful when your sheet has a lot of rows. Last but not least, column descriptions give me the option to share how I expect people to use the columns in the sheet. My team will have all the context they need to understand each column's purpose and contribute to the sheet. When I ask them to, of course. And that's everything you need to know about column types. Spend some time playing with all the different column types. Which ones you'll need depends on the project or assignment, so it doesn't hurt to be an expert. To learn more, visit the Smartsheet Help and Learning Center.